I'm Julia.
I'm Matt.
Yeah.
I'm Han.
Candy.
So right now we're working on a system essentially to find terrain from the ground. So what we're going to be able to do is put down colored pieces of paper such as red, green, whatever, and pull out a track from there. That will allow us to essentially redesign the track really easily. So what we do is we have a picker here, so to pick the color that you want to do. We haven't integrated fully yet, but we also can extract a contour for the color, and then we turn that into a mesh that we send off to simulation team, and simulation can then you load up that mesh and turn it into an actual track. So from the GUI side, the picker is actually pretty easy. All you do is like you go here and like I want say red and green. So I just right now you just click on red and green. It writes to a file behind the scenes like that, and then you send it over to that computer.
This one, it first costume blurs it, so it decreases the noise of the image, and then it converts the image to HSV, which is better for extracting specific colors that you want. So right now we're filtering for hues, and so the region of interest are calculated based on the points that Matt gives us, and right now it's in HSV, so it looks kind of weird, but this is green, this is red. And then afterwards, it creates a threshold using the region of interest. So it calculates the mean and standard deviation of the hue values, and then it thresholds the image based on that. So you can see this is the threshold for the red color, and there's another one. This one's the threshold for the green color. So afterwards, it draws the contours around the specific colors that we chose. So this one is the contour for green. This one's the contour for red. And right now, there's really really little noise because of the region of interest choosing. So like, there's a lot of speckles on this paper right here, but it chooses to ignore it, which is good. And then after that, we want to explain the
Sure. So like after that, we have a contour now. What we do is we need to convert this into a .obj file. So you just take, which is looks like that. It's actually just a long list of vertices, and then at the very end, there are these giant polygons that you have to put together. So to get this file, what you do is you go and follow the contour around in a counterclockwise direction. You write down the vertices while you're doing it, and then you have to save the polygon at the very end that represents those vertices. And then that's what we send off to simulation.
Ooh. By the way, did you guys hear what you mean there?
Oh, you said it in the beginning.
Oh, you did? Okay. Go Beans!
Yeah. Are you calculating the distance between the vertices?
So right now it's absolute pixel distance. So what's going to happen is once we start like doing it on the full track, we'll basically have a static camera set up. So there's going to be some scaling factor that turns pixel distance straight into something that simulation can use in terms of actual distance.
Excellent. Ooh. So next group, yes.
Hi. All so right. I'm part of the simulation team. My name's Adit.
Hi, I'm Kyler.
I'm Amy.
So,
so this is where all the installation is happening. And what we have in front of us right now on one screen is what we were working on in the beginning part of the semester. So we mainly wanted to get the controllers working, controlling cards. So we had a very simple scene. It's, if you just look at it, it's just like a huge plane with something in the middle. So that was our track that we were working with. And then you look, the cars are like right there. So we just wanted something simple to control the cars and start understanding how that works. And yes, yeah. So and then once we had one car working, we wanted to see how we could add multiple cards. So there we see a split screen of four players, and that was when our first approach was create multiple different movement scripts. But then we were able to improve upon that, so it's just one script with different cases. So it's actually, we can add as many players as we want, and it's just add in one more case instead of creating a whole new script. That was a very interesting way we can do that. We also have Oculus integration. However, if we hook up the Oculus right now, we were not able to figure out a way to like tie the Oculus to just one camera. So right now what we see is four split screens, two on your right eye, two on your left eye. So that's something we need to work on. One idea we did have was just have the program running on multiple computers, so one player has just one screen to look at, and that's where the Oculus is hooked up to. That was one approach we had, because the internet, where all the answers are, said you cannot do that. You cannot tie an Oculus to one specific camera where there's multiple cameras in the whole project. So that was one of our problems. So now for just to show, we only have two controllers with us right now. Sorry about that, but there's one controller controlling that cart, and here's the other cart controlling the other remote controlling that cart. So you can see we can have multiple players controlling the same cart, the same screen, and if we collide, it doesn't go through. So that was actually a very big feat. And I don't know if you guys, someone wants to come try it. Okay, so the left is to go straight and forward, the right is to turn. Yeah. So there's still some fine tuning we need to do in terms of how the handling the cart is being controlled. Yeah. So there are some things we need to fine tune. And after we were able to get this working, we wanted to transition into a more decent looking track, which is now on the left screen that we'll switch to really soon. Mm-hmm. And Andre, who's not here right now, he had an interview. He's part of the GUI team, and he made the Android app. So you can actually have your phone control be a controller as well. So it's using the gyroscope inside the phone to control, like turn, move forward, backwards, and I guess we'll switch over to that. Yeah. So this is what we're doing right now. What Andre did was he created a GUI, and the app on this phone is now asking for an IP, and our screen here is showing what the IP of this current computer is. So we'll type in that IP address into the phone, and then...
And the name that I want to display.
Yeah, so...
Once I connect, then I show
up. So now what you see right now is...
The normal one has its camera here, and then so my cart can see what I'm doing here. The problem is that there's lag, so you can see me go off here, but I can't really see what I'm doing until like 20 seconds.
So there's a lot of because we're sending a whole picture through the router. There's a lot of lag. The picture is pixelated. So we want to end the cart's heart. So this was the main problem. Transferring from a very nice terrain to that track was very hard.
This is why we had two scenes going.
Yeah. But you can see there's a lot of physics we had to redo. Actually, gravity is not what we think it would be. It's actually 981 instead of 9.81. That's actually a very common fix for a lot of Unity people who are doing carts and tracks. They say that just how it happened to me. I don't know why, but otherwise the car would keep on flying. I don't know if anyone was around here watching us doing it before. The car was flying off the screen, doing like helicopter spins. So that is currently what we're working on.
Well, beans.